and welcome to another critical reasoning video by Perfect Scores. This is Preetinder Kaur and we have a weakening question in front of us. We need to seriously weaken the argument that is given to us. The argument says discount stores in Goreville Central Shopping District are expected to close within 5 years. So it says discount stores expected to close within 5 years as a result of competition from spendless stores that just opened. Those locations will not stay vacant for long. Those locations won't be vacant for long. And why is that? Because it says in the 5 years since opening of Coulson's, a non-discount department store, a new store is opened at the location of every store in the shopping district that closed because it could not compete with Coulson's. So basically, I hope you are able to see that there's an analogy that is being drawn. Coulson and stores that open up once again at those vacant locations, and SL, which is spendless, and the stores that are expected to open at the same vacant locations in not a very long time. So that is the analogy. And remember, to weaken an analogy, you need to show that the situation that happened here is different from situation that happens here. So A option says many customers of Coulson's are expected to do less shopping there than they did before the spendless store opened. Now that is not able to weaken the argument. Remember, the conclusion is this part, and the premise is this part and this part. So this one is the supporting evidence, the analogy. So to weaken, we have to weaken the conclusion. So nothing about Coulson only will help us to weaken the argument. B says, increasingly the stores that have opened in the central shopping district since Coulson's opened have been discount stores. Now remember, Coulson was a noun discount store. And all the other stores that we are talking about, they're all discount stores. That is why B can help us weaken the argument, because that will show Coulson is a different kind of store. It's a non-discount store. So it has nothing to do with opening or closing of other discount stores. So B can weaken it. C says, at present, the central shopping district has as many stores operating in it as it ever had. That means the number of stores is the same. But that does not weaken the argument. Okay, those stores could be from SL as well. Those stores could be from the same brand or different brands. We do not know whether those are discount or not discount. So that is irrelevant. D says, over the course of the next 5 years, it is expected that Goreville's population will grow at a faster rate than it has. Now, population growth has nothing to do with this argument until and unless it is mentioned in the argument. So D is also eliminated. E says, many stores in the central shopping district sell types of merchandise not available at either Spendless or Coulson's. But we do not know how many people are ready to pay for that merchandise. So E is eliminated. And that is why B is the option that weakens the argument. And hence that is the answer. And thank you so much for watching this video.